बी रेडी, 5 सेकेंड्स
स्टार्ट।
द ऑब्जर्वेशन विच आई विश टू मेक arises from the nature of the business in which our more spectacular increase has been achieved. You have reminded us that within the last 2 years we have initiated in this society 2 new kinds of insurance business, the group insurance and the safeguard policy. The safeguard policy, as all in this room know, is a means whereby anybody in the event of the untimely death of the breadwinner may ensure that his income shall be continued for a number of years after his death, and that during those critical and difficult years when these dependents are growing up and need education and maintenance, and when his widow has neither the experience nor the leisure to earn for and for her children para, provision may be made to protect their interest and to provide the necessary means for their education and maintenance, and that at the same time a lump sum shall be paid when those critical days are over. The fact that this system has met with such an immediate and ready response is a testimonial to the vision and sagacity of our general manager. Limitation is the sincerest form of flattery, and we are glad to see that other companies are copying our good example. But I hope the public will not forget that those who were the pioneers in the business probably know most about it and are best able to adapt their policies to the particular circumstances of individual case. Indeed, the fact that we have today after para, I think some 12 months of experience already, a sum of nearly rupees 2 lakhs assured by this form of policy proves, I think, that the public do realize what a valuable provisions has been made. I am tempted to repeat what I have often said on other platforms and in another connection, that the success of the safeguarding policy is proved wherever the experiment is tried. I pray, gentlemen, now to the other form of novel assurance, where the results are equally gratifying from the public as well as from our own point of view. Refer to the system of group insurance. In these days of intense competition, we are always being told that industry and commerce must rationalize in order to survive. By rationalization is meant para, I suppose, the ruthless cutting down of expenditure where it is not financially profitable, and the careful examination of every rupee spent in order to be quite certain that it is yielding the best results. And I think that one of the difficulties in the way of nationalization lies in the fact that often a firm or a company must find that there are among their staff and in their employment men and women, some of whom have given many years of their lives to building up the business and are perhaps largely responsible for its success, but which are reaching an age at which high salaries which they command are not reflected by efficiency in either energy or output, and where better results might be obtained by employing an energetic person.